just thought about it. Oh my God. You're right. You're totally right. There's really no other explanation. I mean, there's no possible way we could have accidentally touched the button to turn on the TV. And there's no possible way we could have just somehow, like, misplaced some clothes. I mean, wait. Wait 1 minute. Did you hear? It's outside. There might be aliens or werewolves or, oh my God, like Heath Ledger's right over there. Oh my God, it's crazy. We're all gonna die. Come on, demons. It's ridiculous.
It's not funny.
Well, I beg to differ. Oh. Hello? What room number are we in? It's 5. Yeah, it's 521. That is us. Oh, I am, and how are you enjoying your stay? Oh, you're not. And why would that be?
Who is it? Barry!
Oh!
Barry, who is it?
Yeah, I heard that too. Oh, well, I sincerely apologize. We'll try and keep it down. Yeah, you have a great night too.
Well, who was it?
That was Sleeping Beauty over here in 520. They said they want their sleep.
They want their sleep?
Yeah, they said it was the middle of the night.
The news station just said that it was 9 a.m. Okay, this proves there must be some legitimacy to what I'm saying.
Okay, think about it.
Mm-hmm. Thinking.
What have you...
I am still thinking. Thought about it. Not possible.
Okay. Maybe they just screwed up or something. I mean, have you seen Anchorman?
Yeah.
Yeah, he read whatever was on the teleprompter. They probably put like a 9 instead of a 4.
Okay, I guess that could be possible.
See, once again, you're getting way ahead of yourself without even thinking about it.
Then what about my clothes?
They've got to be around here somewhere. I mean, okay, weren't you in the bathroom before things got heated?
Yeah, I guess you're right, I was.
Yeah, I'm usually right. Oh, but wait. Maybe we can do something else.
Well, take back your shirt then.
All right.
Thank you.
What was that?
I don't know. Probably like room service.
Room service? It's 4:30 in the morning, Barry. Pretty sure room service doesn't operate right now.
Okay, okay. I'll check it out.
A breaking new discovery about the case hasn't been made. A man named Lawrence Todd, who just happened to be staying at the same hotel, was enjoying a walk on Chicago's historic Navy Pier when he saw this very couple and snapped a picture for them on his iPhone, which is now in police custody, and then proceeded to send to them via MMS text message. This was the last time either of them were properly photographed before both Barry and his date Susan died their mysterious deaths. This is that photograph. Be sure to join us tonight at 6 when Mr. Todd will join us to tell us what he has only told police in this Channel 5 exclusive. I'm Penelope Corningstone, signing off.
Where am I? What's going on? What am I doing here? What are you doing here? I'm so confused.
Why cry thee? Thou shalt shush, dear maiden.
Barry? Are you all right?
My health be fine, though yours cost concern. And to call me a name for which not my own, thine mind is off rack.
What? I am not getting any of this.
Ah, forsooth, dear maiden. The answer thou seek is in thine hand.
Welcome to the club.
Darkness, my old friend, I've come to talk with you again. because a vision softly creeping left its seeds while I was sleeping. And the vision that was planted in my brain still remains within the sound of silence. In restless dreams I walked alone, narrow streets of cobblestone, neath the halo of a street lamp. I turned my collar to the cold and damp, when my eyes were stared by the flash of a neon light that split the night and touched the sound of silence. And in the naked light I saw 10,000 people, maybe more. People talking without speaking, people hearing without listening, people writing songs that voices never share. No one dared disturb the sound of silence. Fool said I, you do not know. Silence like a cancer grows. Hear my words that I might teach you. Take my arms that I might reach you. But my words like silent raindrops fell and echoed in the wells of silence. The people bowed and prayed to the neon god they made. And the sign flashed out its warning in the words that it was forming. And the sign said the words of the prophets are written on the subway walls, tenement halls, whispering sounds of silence.